Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey everyone, this is Frank, and today I will be playing some more games with Affinity in Modern. I'm mainly here to try out the new edition from M15, Ensoul Artifact. This is my current list where I added two Ensoul Artifact instead of Thoughtcast that I had earlier. I like what it does. I mean, I also had it in the Affinity deck that I played at Grand Prix Boston, or, well, Grand Prix close to Boston at least. And there, well, I finished in 9th place, and the couple games where I drew this pair of scissors, it was pretty good. I mean, it usually is like a 2 mana, 5 power haste creature. If you just put it on a Mox Opal or a Springleaf Drum, that's fine. Put it on a Vault Scourge, for example, and you can create your own Baneslayer Angel. I mean, you get a 5/5 flying lifelink on turn 2 that you can attack with immediately. And it's also very nice on Darksteel Citadel that you create an indestructible 5/5 guy that is sometimes hard to deal with. So I just added 2 to the deck. I think that's fine, and this is how I've been playing it. But for this video, I guess because it's a new card, I might as well increase the chances of actually drawing it. So let's just go to Galvanic Blast and Master of Ethereum and add 2 more Ensoul Artifacts to the deck. This is not what I would recommend you to play in the tournament, but this way you might see more Ensouls in the game that I get to record. Before I move on to the matches, I want to take a quick look at a different Affinity build. This is the deck that you say go to made the top 8 with at Grand Prix Kobe quite recently. It's also a version of Affinity with Ensoul Artifact, but it's quite a different one. It features a lot of Burn, Galvanic Blast, and Shrapnel Blast, and also has Stormergoyf in the main deck. And it does not have Arcbound Ravager or Steel Overseer. Now, I can understand where this version is coming from, especially with Ensoul Artifact. The idea of, I mean, you just make a 5 power guy, attack a couple times, and then finish off the opponent with Shrapnel Blast or Galvanic Blast. It's a game plan. I still prefer my version, because I think especially game 1, I feel like cards like Arcbound Ravager and Steel Overseer are just more impactful. It's easier to win the game with those cards than with something like a Tarmogoyf, even though Tarmogoyf is obviously good. The artifacts typically deal more damage in fast bursts. In addition to that, cards like Arcbound Ravager and Steel Overseer turn on stuff like Mox Opal and Cranial Plating. Then you can always cast them even if you don't have a colored source, so they have those advantages. Now, this deck might have enough colored sources to play all of the colored cards. I mean, next to Glimmer Void and Springleaf Drum and Mox Opal, which I also have, this deck includes some copies of Mana Confluence and 4 Chromatic Stars, which kind of take the place of I guess Signal Pest in this deck. I mean, the Chromatic Stars make a lot of sense if you want to go into this route. I still prefer my version. I think also with Galvanic Blast and Shrapnel Blast, which are often not the best cards to have in your opening hand, they don't really turn on any of the artifact synergies. And I feel like the explosiveness and artifact synergies is the main power of Affinity. Now, I guess Tarmogoyf might be good after sideboarding. I mean, when everyone brings in Shatterstorms and Stony Silence and whatnot, then, well, you still have a Tarmogoyf. You can win the game with that, so that's definitely a game plan. But I'm still going to stick with my version. I think especially in game 1 it is stronger. Tarmogoyf might be something to keep in mind for the post-sideboard matches. But I just wanted to show this list as an alternative build and explain why I prefer mine. So, just as a reminder, this is the deck that I will be battling with in the next matches, and I'll see you there.